In today's lecture, we will see that how a voltage amplifier is act as a voltage follower circuit and also act as a summing amplifier. In previous video lectures, we have also seen the operation of operational amplifier with its various practical and ideal specifications, and then we move to the inverting amplifier and non-inverting amplifier, where we have also concluded the lecture by calculating the gain for the inverting amplifier and as well as for the non-inverting amplifier. The gain for inverting amplifier comes out to be equals to A is equal to V out by VI, which is equals to R2 by R1 minus of R2 by R1. By this minus sign is showing that this is a inverting amplifier, and where R2 is feedback resistance, which is provided between output voltage and the negative terminal of operational amplifier. So same gain is calculated for the non-inverting amplifier, whose value comes out to be V out by V in is equals to 1 plus R2 by R1. Right, this is for non-inverting amplifier. Now we will discuss the operational amplifier as a voltage follower, or this is also known as a buffer circuit. For this, we will use a non-inverting circuit, non-inverting amplifier, where voltage is provided at the positive terminal of the operational amplifier and the negative terminal of the operational amplifier is directly fed with this output voltage without any connection of feedback resistance R2 or any input resistance R1. So this type of a circuit, when we are using this, forms the voltage amplifier. So now we will see mathematically that how it is act as a voltage follower circuit. For non-inverting amplifier, as we know, the gain is equals to A is equals to V out by V in, which is equals to 1 plus R2 by R1. So from here we can see R2 is 0 and R1 is also not there. So this comes out to be 0 value. R2 by R1, this value comes out to be 0, and the voltage expression for the gain expression from here is equals to V0 by VI is equals to 1. From here we can conclude it that V out, if V out by VI is equals to 1, which means V out is equals to VI, which means that output voltage will follow the input voltage only. If V in voltage is at 10 volt, then output voltage will also be 10 volt, which is showing that output voltage is just following the input voltage. That is why its name is voltage follower, and this is also known as a buffer circuit. Now our next topic is summing amplifier. Summing amplifier is a amplifier which adds the input voltage, right? So we will use here operational amplifier to make a adder circuit or a summing amplifier. So from this summing amplifier, finally we will conclude this V out is proportional to sum of all input voltages. Suppose here input voltages are V1, V2 and V3. So output voltage will comes out to proportional to the V1 plus V2 plus V3. So this can be also concluded by mathematical calculations. So from here, as we also know that we will use the virtual ground concept for solving the operational amplifier for its simplification. So if this is an ideal operational amplifier, the gain for operational amplifier will be open loop gain, for the operational amplifier will be infinite. And if this operational amplifier is provided with the negative feedback, as we can see over here, it is provided with the negative feedback, then we can use हेयर वर्चुअल ग्राउंड कंसेप्ट. सो वर्चुअल ग्राउंड कंसेप्ट कैन बी यूज एंड वर्चुअल ग्राउंड कंसेप्ट सेज दैट इफ हेयर इफ द वोल्टेज VD is very very small over here. It is around -10^-6 volt, which means very small, which is nearly equals to zero. This provides the V plus will be equals to V minus. So according to virtual ground concept, this voltage and this voltage will be same. From here we can see this positive terminal voltage of a operational amplifier is zero. Means V plus is equals to 0 volt and this V minus volt comes out to be 0 volt also because of the virtual ground concept. So at this node voltage will be 0 volt. So for simplification we have calculated the V minus voltage which is comes out to be 0 volt. Now we will do further calculations for proving this is as a summing amplifier. So as you can see here, there we are using a three voltage sources V1, V2 and V3 and keep remembering this voltage is zero voltage. So V1, the current flowing from V1 is I1 and from V2 is I2 and V3 is I3 and feedback current from here V0 is suppose equals to IF. So from here we can put a KVL equation at this node and KCL equation is says that algebraic sum of all the current should all the incoming current should be equals to algebraic sum of all the outgoing current. So here at this node all the currents are incoming current. So the final KCL equation we can write it as a I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus IF is equal to 0. All the incoming currents can be added up and there is no leaving current, so that is 0. So now we will find the final expressions for this I1, I2, I3 and IF and then we will substitute those expression in this equation. For example, this is your first equation. Now we will calculate the values of I1, I2 and I3 in terms of V1, V2 and V3. So from here, I1 current can be written as a V1 minus I1 is equals to V1 minus, if this voltage is 0 volt, V1 minus 0 divided by this R1. I2 is equals to V2 minus, this voltage is also 0 divided by R2. And I3 is equals to V3 minus 0 by R3. And similarly for this feedback IF current, IF is equals to V out minus 0 by RF. Now we will substitute all these values in the previous equation, in the first equation. So this comes out to be, if we substitute this value here, I1 plus I2 plus I3 is plus IF is equal to 0. So this comes out to be V1 by R1 plus V2 by R1 plus V3 by R1 plus V0 by RF is equal to 0. So this is R2 and this is R3. Now from here we will separate this V0 term and we will separate input terms. So it comes out to be V1 by R1, V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3 is equals to minus of V0 by RF, right? So our final equation comes out to be this. I will rewrite it as V1 by R1 plus V2 by R2 plus V3 by R3 is equals to minus of V0 by RF. So from here you can see this V naught is comes out to be somewhat proportional to this V1 plus V2 plus V3. But for more simplification, that you can see it as a summing circuit. For example, if you put R1, R2 and R3 is equals to R. So this value comes out to be V1 plus V2 plus V3, and R is whole common. For this R1, R2, R3 are same. This is equals to R. So it comes out to be common, and this will be equals to minus of R by Rf into V0. Right? From here you can see this V0 is proportional to V1 plus V2 plus V3, which is a summing circuit. For more simplification, you can see V0 is comes out to be minus of Rf by R V1 plus V2 plus V3. If R is equals to Rf, if these both terms are equal, then it comes out to be V0 is equals to minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3. This is showing that the output voltage is a sum of all the input voltages V1 plus V2 plus V3. So this becomes as a summing amplifier. So the same circuit we can use as a average circuit. So how we will use it as an average circuit? By varying this value Rf by R. So you can conclude from here that by changing these values, Rf or R value, if you want to change, you can use it as a summing amplifier and also use it as an average amplifier. For average amplifier, what you have to do is just, if the value is minus, I'm rewriting the equation, minus Rf by R V1 plus V2 plus V3. And for the average amplifier, if we put the value of Rf by R is equals to 1 by N, where this N is the number of input voltages. So here number of input voltages is 3, 1, 2 and 3, V1, V2 and V3. So here for this circuit, it comes out to be 1 by 3. And we can put this value in above equation. So V0 will comes out to be minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3 upon 3. So this is comes out to be average value. So this operational amplifier can be act as a summing amplifier, and you can use this operational amplifier or this circuit as a average circuit for calculating the average by varying the values of R1, R2 and R3. Similarly, you can use the inverting you can use the non-inverting amplifier for the summing circuit, forming the summing circuit by just grounding these terminals. Means you can ground this terminal over here and provide this circuit at the positive terminal of the operational amplifier. So this could also make the summing amplifier by connecting these voltages V1, V2, V3 at the non-inverting terminal. So from here, in this summing amplifier, because it is connected at the negative terminal of the operational amplifier, so that's why V0 comes out to be equals to minus of V1 plus V2 plus V3, because this is the minus sign is showing because the inputs are providing at the negative terminal of the operational amplifier. If these voltages are provided at this positive terminal of the operational amplifier and this negative terminal of the operational amplifier is grounded, so at that time the voltages, output voltage comes out to be equals to V1 plus V2 plus V3. There is no negative sign, so there will be no negative sign. So that this will shows that the input voltages are provided at the non-inverting terminal, which means at this positive terminal. So you can solve, you can calculate the or you can prove non-inverting amplifier as a summing amplifier. That is your homework question. So you can solve it by your own. Or till then, thank you, and hope so we will cover many other video lectures.